This entitled mother has gone on vacation during the holiday season. A great break for her neighbors, but a complete disaster for those who are also on vacation. Just trying to have a relaxing time. What awful things does she do to ruin everyone's holiday? Happy birthday, today's your birthday, and on with the revamped show. My friend and I had planned a trip to an amusement park in Copenhagen, Denmark, named Tivoli. We were celebrating her birthday and we had an amazing day. We both had school the next day, so we decided to take a few more rides before heading home. We chose the oldest ride of the park, the 100-year-old roller coaster, of the same name, the roller coaster. We get in line and wait for our turn, like 15 minutes of waiting. We get through the line and get ready to get the best cart possible. I have added a picture of the carts below. My friend and I do, like the others in line for the ride, and quickly get into the cart to assure the best seating. We were lucky and got the first row seats. We sit down, laugh, and are just enjoying our trip. The carts are at this moment almost full. Just as we pull down the safety bar, we see a woman standing, staring at us. She is standing with her 7-year-ish old boy, and she looks really mad. Can I help you?
Get out of that cart! My baby saw it first!
My friend and I look confusedly at each other. We both saw that nice kid and entitled mum clearly were behind us in the line, and the cart is ready to take off. Because I am closer to the edge, I talk to the entitled mum. I'm sorry, ma'am, but the safety belt has been locked. We cannot get out now. I am sure that if you ask the staff, you can get the front row seat of the next cart.
How dare you be so rude! My son has waited all day to sit in that cart! Get out!
NK had started to tug his mum's bag. He looks embarrassed.
Mom, it's okay. I can just wait for the next one.
Just to mention, but the line for this ride is not that bad. And the same goes with the seats. You get through the line in under 10 minutes. And if you want the cart in the front, you can just ask the staff and wait a turn to get it. My friend and I keep trying to get the mum to calm down, which we do not succeed with. She keeps arguing with us and claiming the cart as hers. Then the ticket guy sees what's going on, and he asks the woman to calm down. She then furiously takes a step back with her son, and then continues to stare at us. Like, really staring into our souls. Nice Kid is now fire engine red in the head, trying to let his mum know that it is okay. The ride begins, and as we turn around the corner, we can see entitled mum's eyes following us through the dark. When the ride is over and my friend and I are about to leave, we see EM again, glaring at us, and then taking a seat in the front seat cart. Is it any surprise that if an entitled parent is at a theme park, they're going to use their child to get the best seat that they possibly can? I think we're yet to meet an entitled parent with some tact, someone who tries to manipulate other people using their child, but maybe also uses some politeness at the same time. It's always just straight out demanding exactly what they want because child. It's always such weird justification as well. My child saw the front row seat first. What, from halfway back in the line, like everybody else did. Right, so this happened about 5 years ago when I was working as a new qualified social worker. I know, lynch mob me. I don't anymore. It was a nightmare. It has been a rough morning and, long story short, I had spit and vomit on me. As pretty standard practice, I kept a spare set of court clothes in my car, so I had something to change into. But I felt pretty disgusting and wanted a shower, so I took an early lunch and went to my gym nearby the office to shower and change. I showered, came out, and put my hair up in a towel turban, and walked to go back to the lockers. Changing area was empty except for one kid, a boy about 8 or 9. A bit weird for him to be alone, but I assumed his mum must have been in the only occupied stall, so I didn't think too much of it. I smiled to acknowledge him and got to my locker to grab my things to change into. At this point, the boy, EK, looked at me, pointed at my towel turban and said,
"What's that?"
"Oh, it's a towel turban. Pretty neat, huh? It stays up better than a regular towel."
"Cool."
And started to reach for my head. "Excuse me, what are you doing?"
"I just wanted to see it."
No, I'm using it, sorry. At this point in my life, I'm pretty used to kids being a bit inappropriate, and it's my job to make sure they understand, but I wasn't expecting here. He looked a bit ticked, but went back to his mum's phone. I get dressed quickly and get to my things to go over to the mirror and take the turban off to hairdry my hair. I'm flipping my hair around to get it dried, and I notice that this kid comes up to the mirror, then leaves again. I think nothing of it and finish drying my hair, turn the hairdryer off, reach for my turban, and it isn't there. I know what he's done, and I whip around and look at him, and he's turning a shade of red, but staring fixed on his phone so as to ignore me. I'm trying to remain calm, but I've been spat at, vomited on, and now someone has stolen my towel turban. I walk back over and do my best, I've had enough of this bullcrap, voice, and say, please return the turban now. He keeps ignoring me, so I repeat, please return the turban now. He's gone a huge shade of red, refuses to look up at me, and mumbles something like,
I didn't take it.
I've had it at this point, so go over to the only occupied stall and knock on the door. Excuse me, is this your son out here? EM opens the door and looks at me thoroughly annoyed.
What?
Is this your son? He has taken my towel turban. I have asked him for it back, but he is not returning it. Please ask him to hand it back, and I'll not inform the gym staff.
What the frick is a towel turban?
I start to explain, but EK says,
it's a hair towel that stays up better than a normal towel.
We both look at him, and she says,
okay, so what do you want?
I want my towel turban back, please.
Well, he wouldn't just take something. You obviously just lost it. You shouldn't go around accusing people because you lose things.
Me getting annoyed. Well, he will have no problem then emptying his bag. If he has it, he can just hand it back. And if I'm mistaken, I will apologize. EM looks at EK and it's obvious to anyone that he's lying. But she just says,
don't be freaking stupid. I'm not letting you rummage through his things like he's some kind of thief. Look at you. You are harassing a little boy in a changing room.
I inhale to try and stop my eyes doing a 360 degree roll and say, I'm not asking to touch anything. I'm asking for you to go through his bag for my turban. That is all. If you are not willing, I will go to the staff and ask them to sort this out. I know it's just a freaking towel turban, but theft is theft. And it's pink and cute, so I'm not letting anyone have it.
So you're threatening me now?
I know a circular argument when I hear one. So I go to the door, lean out, and call for someone to come and sort this out. Enter gym trainer dude. What's going on? He looks between the three of us, and the kid has gone back to staring a hole through the phone. And EM positions herself between the trainer and entitled kid.
This crazy bee is harassing my son and trying to go through his bag. She needs throwing out. She...
That isn't what happened. Her son has taken my towel turban and I would like it returned. I just keep looking at this kid and trainer says,
okay, so what happened, mate? Did you take the towel?
EK mumbles something about how I must have lost it and EM jumps in and says,
see, he didn't take it. He's so traumatized he can barely say anything.
She then bends down to him and hugs him, saying it'll be all right and she won't let me get away with this, very dramatically. I look at the trainer and explain the whole event, and he says,
okay, so why don't we just check his bag?
EK starts dramatically wailing, and EM starts ranting about how this is harassment. The trainer looks uncomfortable and says,
that's literally the only way I can think to solve this.
EM then stands up and tries to push past me, but I'm not moving, and the room is so small she fails. She starts swearing and thrusts the kid's backpack at the trainer, saying,
fine, check it. He hasn't taken it, and when you don't find it, I want her thrown out. You to apologize and get the manager.
EK wails. The trainer obviously finds the pink wet turban towel in the bag. He picks it up and kind of just looks at it. EK wails even more and tries to grab it, but the trainer holds it out of his reach.
Right, so this is yours.
Yes, thank you. I stuff the coveted turban towel into my bag and get out my car keys and ID lanyard. As I put the lanyard over my head, something audibly clicked in EM's head. That's a social worker ID. She yanks EK's arm, snatches the bag from trainer, and I move to let her pass. The trainer looks super confused, and I explain that she must have been embarrassed that her son stole my turban, but I knew she was panicking because she realized what my job was, and that her son was out of school stealing pink, wet turban towels. Most entitled parents think their children are angels and could do nothing wrong, unlike the rest of us who realize nobody's perfect and we all do wrong, including, and sometimes especially, children. I think they must put blinders up, because in their mind it's like, well, if my child has done something wrong and I'm the parent, I must have done something wrong, which is not always the case. You've only done something wrong if you don't acknowledge when your child has done something wrong and do the right thing as a parent and actually try and correct their behavior. Trying to ignore their bad behavior is only going to set them up for a life of failure and only makes you a failed parent. So a bit of background. It was our school sports day. We were taken to a small stadium where we could do some fun games like football, tug of war, or tag rugby. and some competitions as well. Sprints at 100, 200 and 400 meter, high jump and shot put. There was a large stand full of seats where students could go to rest or get some stuff from their bags. To the left was a stand where parents could sit and watch their kids compete. It was about half the size of the student stands, because not many parents came to watch, since it was really hot around the time sports day would happen. So let's meet the cast. Me, absolutely no clue who this is, EM, your typical Karen, EK Hellspawn, PT, PE teacher. So I was running the 100 meter and was probably the best in my grade at the time. I was taller than everyone else in my grade at the time, which helped with my speed. So I ran the race against like 7 other guys and came first place by about a meter. One of those guys, EK, was some rich kid who always used to act cool by showing off as if he had everything he wanted. Fast forward to after the award ceremony, everyone is going to get their bags from the stands or go to their parents. I just walked alone, gold medal in hand, to go get a drink from the vending machine. As I turn the corner, I see EM and EK with EK fake crying. It was pretty obvious. And turn towards the vending machine. As he sees me, he points towards me and says,
"Get him, mama."
They both start walking towards me. I hadn't noticed until it was too late though.
"You don't deserve that medal."
I'm sorry, what? I wasn't paying attention as I was trying to decide what to get.
"Give me the medal now and I won't report you to the head of the PE department."
"Why? I won this medal."
"No, you didn't. I was recording and saw you start before everyone else. Now give me the medal, otherwise I'll have you suspended."
Me, still being a kid at the time, was scared crapless, and you could see it. I actually thought I did cheat and didn't want to get into trouble. I was actually going to give EM the medal, until PE teacher walked up to us. I'm guessing he thought something was wrong because I looked pretty scared and EK was fake crying.
"Is anything wrong?"
"Oh, nothing's wrong."
PT turns to EK and asks,
"What's wrong?"
EK fakes sobbing.
"He cheated in the race when I was supposed to win."
"Is that true?"
Grade 6 me stayed silent. EM pretty hesitant to speak now.
"That's right, he started before everyone else."
I got even more scared now. PT was the person standing by the starting line to make sure we didn't get a head start. I fully expected to be in trouble, but then...
"He did, huh? Well, I was standing right beside the line,
and he was just fine. Started off with the rest of the kids."
"You're lying, I have a video here."
"Please show me the video then."
"I'm going to talk to the principal and get you fired."
She just stormed off with EK, in before any of us could say anything. I was a bit shaken after that, so PT got me an orange juice. He's a pretty cool guy. When you have that one good teacher in school, you just never want them to leave because it can be so rare. There are a lot of neutral teachers that are just doing the job or doing the best they can, but it just seems like there are a lot more bad teachers than there are the good ones that redeem it. Not to mention the experience of having to deal with parents like this. When you're just a kid, you need someone to advocate for you, because it can be intimidating to have a grown-up yelling at your face, especially accusing you that you cheated in a race. She starts to gaslight him and make him think, maybe I did actually cheat. And why? All because their kid didn't win the race? Is it really worth your kid getting a medal that way? Pretty sad if you think it is. So me and my parents were on vacation, and because my parents wanted to celebrate, they chose a really nice hotel, Ritz-Carlton, and we were going to stay there for 3 nights. I was walking home on my own because I wanted to take a look around, and my family was at a friend's place. I was allergic to something at their house, and I didn't like them anyways. So anyway, I was walking home when I saw this woman with a crazy expression and was shouting out to anyone who would come close to her. And me, being the innocent child I was, walked close to her. The woman grabbed me by the arm and shouted,
"Are you a tourist?"
"Yes, ma'am. What's the matter?" I was very timid and shy at the time.
"What hotel are you staying at?"
At this point I was very confused, but decided to be polite and tell her anyway. Ritz-Carlton. At this point, once I mentioned the name, I saw her eyes light up. She gripped me harder on the arm, and at this point I started attracting attention, since by her appearance she was not my mother.
"Son, you look very kind. Could you help me and do me a huge favor?"
"Sure."
"Could you let me stay in your room?"
"What? I'm sorry, but even if my parents let me, there are only 3 beds. I was confused but still wanted to help, and at this point I tried twisting my arm away.
Don't you struggle when I'm talking to you?
I'm sorry. I had a weak personality, and at any point a grown-up got angry, I would immediately wilt.
Good. Now you have to give me your room.
I'm sorry, but no. I put on a firm voice like my dad taught me.
Give me your room!
At this point, EM is squealing like a baby and is getting red now. At this point, Hero appears and immediately goes to security and begins explaining. EM is still holding onto me and her fingernails are digging into my skin. It's starting to hurt.
Let go!
Hero and security.
Ma'am, are you okay? No, this young man is taking my room key and wants my room. Stop him!
At this point, Hero and security chuckled.
Why are you laughing? Arrest him now!
Hero and security. Ma'am, I fail to see the threat this child is to you, and he is obviously trying to get away. Let go of him now.
Not until he gives me the key card.
Kid, give her the card. I can prove that it is my family's room. I can tell you the name of the owner of the room. At this point, Hero and the security sense that something is wrong. They bring us to the front desk and explain the situation. And me and EM are asked to tell them the name of the person who booked the room. EM says a random name.
Are you sure, ma'am?
Oh, I said it wrong. It's...
says another random name. Your turn, kid. I say my dad's name. At this point, EM knows that she is screwed. She pushes Hero and barges through security. But instead of escaping, she runs, trips over herself, and face plants onto the floor. Security runs over to her and pulls her up. She rees and does a dramatic dive to the floor.
Why did you push me?
EM starts screaming obscenities and racist slurs, and calls me a gosh darn room-stealing son of a. The popo arrive and I press charges. Fortunately, me and my family continue on and have a great time. This person was like level 1 scammer. Tourists normally are the victim of scams and crimes, because usually they're a bit more vulnerable in a foreign place. But the con artist usually can pick them out without having to grab their arm and scream at them, "Are you a tourist?" Now, the mistake they made here was just getting too close to crazy. If you see crazy, maybe just take a few extra steps to the left. Who knows, it might save you someone digging their fingernails into your arm.
Submit your story to be read on the channel at voiceyhearstories@gmail.com and join our Voicey veteran community at r/voiceyhear. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode. All right, Voicey veterans, I'll see you in the next one.